We continue the thermodynamic temperature scales for Carnot engines. As you remember that the Carnot engine says us, the thermal efficiency can be calculated temperatures with temperatures instead of heats. Okay, how can it be done? And we look the formulation now. First of all, the reversible engine, because this is the reversible, so important. Maybe we can write here, this is the reversible. Okay, Carnot engine. Okay. For reversible, for calculating the temperature, thermal efficiency of the reversible heat engines or reversible Carnot cycles is not so important, is function of TH and TL. Okay. Also, QH divided by QL is also function of TH and TL. Therefore, first we calculate the thermal efficiency with temperature, and for calculating the heat transfer from hot from heat transfer from hot thermal reservoir divided by the heat transfer from low thermal reservoir is a function of temperature. Okay, for this situation, we have you remember the this engine. Okay, first again we remember so quickly, hot term reservoir, hot reservoir T1, low reservoir T3. All we use three reversible engines. Reversible engines A first, Q1 get Q1 and reject the Q2 and we get the WA from net output, and for the reversible heat engine from we use T2 and reject the T3 and the net work output the WB. But we use three reversible heat engine between the same thermal reservoir, but of course we can use four. One reversible heat engine, reversible heat engine C, it use Q1 and Q3 and the work output is WC. And for the situation, we look the formulation for all three engines separately. Okay, for reversible engine A, Q1 divided by Q2 is equal to function of T1 and T2. For Q2 and Q3, Q2 divided by Q3 is a function of temperature 2 and temperature 3. Okay, this is the A engine, this is the B engine, and this is the C engine. Okay, and heat engine C. Q1 divided by Q3 is a function of temperature 1 and temperature 3. For the situation, Q1 divided by Q3 is calculated is Q1 divided by Q2 multiple Q divided by Q3. In the situation, Q3 goes destroy each other. Therefore, for the situation, for this manner, function of T1 and T3 is equal to function of T1 and T2 multiple function of T2 and T3. Okay. For the situation, function T1 and T3 is calculated phi temperature 1 divided by phi temperature 2. Okay, for function of temperature 2 and temperature 3, phi temperature 2 and phi divided by phi temperature 3. In the same manner, you can calculate like this. Okay, for the situation phi t, it means phi t, the several functions phi t satisfies this equation and the choice is completely arbitrary. And Lord Kelvin first proposed taking the phi t is t to define a thermodynamic temperature scale. It means that phi t is, we can use Kelvin scale, okay? Not centigrade scale, we use Kelvin scale for reversible engine. This is so important. Therefore, totally reversible process can be done for Carnot cycle. Therefore, we can use this phenomena for Carnot cycle. Therefore, As you see here, Q1, Q3 is equal to function of T1, T3, and is equal to phi temperature 1 divided by phi temperature T. Phi T is, as you see, is Kelvin temperature scale. Therefore, QH and QH divided by QL is equal to TH divided by TL. Okay. This is independent thermodynamic temperature scale. And I reminded again, therefore, if there is QH divided by QL is equal to TH divided by TL, therefore, we can calculate here and temperature reversible is equal to 1 minus TL divided by TH. This is reversible heat engines. It means that Carnot cycle. Okay. And for the situation, we can use this formulation or this independent temperature scales for Carnot heat cycle or refrigeration heat cycle. Okay. Because this is all reversible. For solid lines, high temperature reversible comes QH and the heat reject between QL and we get W net. For dot lines, we get the heat from low temperatures. We put the energy to the system as pump, as you remember. After that, we transfer the heat from the high temperature reservoir. This is also refrigeration cycle. This is the heat engine. This is the refrigeration cycle. But for all situation, QH divided by QL is equal to TH divided by TL. Okay. Because all heat engines or refrigerations are totally reversible. This is so important. Totally reversible. Okay. For the situation, another heat engine setup is here. But at low temperature, reservoir is assigned 273.16 Kelvin. This is water at triple point. As you know, that triple points because water is liquid phase, gas phase, and solid phase at the together. Okay, for the situation, it's not so big issue. Temperature is equal to, for this temperature, high temperature reservoir, temperature is 373.16 QH divided by QL. Also, we can use this formulation. Okay, this is not so important. Therefore, if we calculate the temperature, we can use QH and QL together. Now, therefore, we calculate the thermal efficiency is 70%. Okay, because we can use temperatures instead of heat. Okay. Now, this is the same example, and in the situation, temperature efficiency of the Carnot heat engine is 70%, and we calculate again, temperature is equal to 1 minus QL 300 divided by 100. It means 0.7, also it means 70%. For the situation, we looked at this figure here. This figure here, okay. And we looked at reversible heat engine. It means 70% because high temperature reservoir at 1000 Kelvin, low temperature reservoir at 300 Kelvin. Okay. If it is reversible, if this is reversible heat engine, but if it is reversible heat engine, the thermal efficiency must be smaller than the reversible heat engine. This is true. because reversible heat engines thermal efficiency is 70%, but irreversible heat engine is 45%. This is true. It can be done. But the thermal efficiency cannot be 80%. This is impossible. Okay. They said that if thermal efficiency is equal to thermal efficiency reversible, this is reversible heat engine. Okay. This is reversible heat engine. But the thermal efficiency is smaller than the reversible thermal efficiency. This is irreversible heat engine. This is reversible heat engine. This is irreversible heat engine. Okay. And if thermal efficiency is greater than the reversible heat engine, this is impossible. This is impossible. Okay. Because Carnot rules says us. Also, Carnot rules, as you remember, Carnot principles, as you hear, all the reversible heat engines is same thermal efficiency because they working with the same thermal reversers. But in the situation, reversible heat engine thermal efficiency is smaller than the reversible thermal efficiency. Okay. This gives us a Carnot principle, Carnot rules also. This also, we can use Carnot rules here. But this is the another rules. Any thermal efficiency cannot be also cannot be greater or cannot be increased. The reversible heat engine's thermal efficiency, this is impossible. Okay. Also, this is so important, this formulation. Any heat engine, because this is so important, any heat engine thermal efficiency can be calculated 1 minus QL divided by QH. But for Carnot engine, totally reversible Carnot engine, thermal efficiency reversible can be calculated 1 minus TL divided by TH. Okay. This is so important. Maybe I can, like here, for any heat engine, we use heats for calculating temperature thermal efficiency, but Carnot heat engines we can use temperatures instead of heats because all the processes are total inverse. Therefore, we can use independent temperature scales, thermodynamic temperature scales. And now we solve the problem. First, a Carnot heat engine receives 500 kilojoule of heat per cycle from the high temperature source. Okay. It gives 500 kilojoule per cycle at source of 652 centigrees and rejects the heat to the low temperature at 30 centigrees. And we don't know what is QL. And they ask that what about the determine the thermal efficiency of this Carnot engine. First, we calculate the thermal efficiency with temperatures, of course, because it gives the temperature hot and temperature low. And after that, what about the amount of heat rejected from the to the sink per cycle? Therefore, they ask what is the QL. For the situation, first we calculate the thermal efficiency. What about the thermal efficiency? Thermal efficiency can be calculated with temperatures because all the processes are irreversible. And thermal efficiency, Carnot heat engine is equal to thermal efficiency reversible is equal to 1 minus TH divided by TL. This is so important, guys. We use Kelvin scale. Okay, this is so important. TL is 30 centigrade. Therefore, we use 30 plus 273 Kelvin. What about TH? TH is 652 centigrade, and we put the BV at the 373 Kelvin, and we get the Kelvin. Okay, this is, I'm going to repeat that this is Kelvin. Therefore, we can calculate the thermal efficiencies 0.672, it means 67.2%. Okay, this is so high thermodynamic thermal efficiency. And what about the QL? QL is equal to, as you know, that QL divided by QH is equal to TL divided, as you see here, QL divided by QH. H is equal to TL divided by TH. Okay, for the situation, QL is equal to QH multiple TL divided by TH. For the situation, again, you don't remember, we use Kelvin scale. After that, we put 273 for Kelvin. After that, we multiply 500 kilojoule, and the heat reject, the amount of the heat rejected is 164 kilojoule. Okay, this is so easy problem. And what about the quality of energy? As you see here, high temperature reservoir, and for the low temperature reservoir is always at 303 Kelvin. And what about the for the, we make the table here, we can say this is also table. And if the temperature, high temperature reservoir temperature is increased, TH is increased, the thermal efficiency is also increased. As you see here, this is the same with the previous example, because this is 653 centigrade is equal to 925 Kelvin. Okay, this is 610 centigrade. But in this situation, this is also 30 centigrade. This is the 303 Kelvin. This is same with previous example. For the situation, guys, if we low temperature constant, okay, low temperature reservoir temperature, this temperature is constant, TL, if TL is constant, and if we, for this situation, temperature increases with thermal efficiency. I mean that if the temperature is, hot temperature is 350, thermal temperature of, thermal efficiency is 13.4. And if we determine the TH is 700, the temperature of the thermal efficiency is the 56.7. And like in example, previous example, temperature is high temperature reservoir temperature is 925, and the thermal efficiency is the 67.2 percent. Therefore, if we increase the high temperature reservoir, temperature of the high temperature reservoir increases, therefore thermal efficiency is also increases. Okay, for the situation, therefore if we use high temperature for high temperature reservoir, it means that we use great temperature, therefore energy quality is also increase, it means thermal efficiency is increased. As you see here for this figure, the quality, energy quality is, the higher temperature of the thermal energy, the higher its quality. It means that if we use higher temperature at thermal reservoir, and that we can get the higher quality, it means higher thermal efficiency. Okay, for the situation, it comes from the theoretical limit. Okay, from the this formulation, it's so simple. And what about the Carnot refrigeration and heat pump? Okay, for the situation, again, I reminded, all processes are reversible. Therefore, Carnot heat engine can be reversed And for this situation, Carnot refrigerator cycle or Carnot heat pump cycle is done. And we're reminded what is for the situation, maybe this is Carnot engine and this is the Carnot refrigeration cycle. If we take in account this situation, this is refrigerator, because it is cooling is important. If we think is this medium, this is heat pump. Okay, as you remember, and all the process are reversed from the heat engines. And what about the refrigerator? This is, again, Carnot rules is similar to Carnot refrigerator and heat pump. First of all, we use coefficient of performance instead of thermal efficiency in refrigerator and heat pump. And as you remember that, coefficient of performance of refrigerator is equal to 1 divided by QH divided by QL minus 1. For coefficient of performance of the heat pump is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus QL divided by QH. And for Carnot refrigerator and heat pump, because all is totally reversible process, for the situation, we can use temperatures instead of heats. Therefore, coefficient of performance refrigerator for reversible, 1, we can use TH instead of QH. Okay, in the same manner for heat pump, the same equation is used, but for the situation, we use temperature TL divided by TH instead of QL divided by QH. Okay, this is same with heat pumps, or in the same manner, I mean it, in the same logic. For the situation, we can calculate a reversible refrigerator. We calculate the coefficient performance of refrigerator. Okay, reversible refrigerator is 11 for this temperature. Please, you can calculate, okay, by your own. This is 11. Reversible refrigerator, coefficient of performance of the reversible refrigerator is 7. This is true because reversible is greater than the irreversible. I mean that COP reversible is greater than the COP irreversible. Okay, this is true. But this is impossible because COP refrigerator is 13, but this 13 is greater than the reversible refrigerator. This is impossible. It is same in the same logic, I mean that with this. As you remember, this is the same one. Okay, all the same. Again, we can repeat it. If the reversible heat engine is 11, it's okay. But irreversible refrigerator COP, coefficient of performance of the refrigerator is 7. This is true because irreversible thermal efficiency and irreversible coefficient of performance is always smaller than the reversible heat refrigerator. But if the coefficient of performance is greater than the reversible refrigerator, it is impossible. Okay. It cannot be done like this. And what about the problem? In your book and in your last presentation that I prepared, I use Fahrenheit. But in the situation, I calculate first the Fahrenheit to Kelvin, therefore I calculate the coefficient of performance. First of all, what explain the example 6.6. This is the inventor claims to have developed a refrigerator. That means it's refrigerated at space. This is refrigerated, I mean the TH GL. Okay. This is 35 centigrees Fahrenheit, pardon, Fahrenheit. And operating room where the temperature is 75 degrees. So I think this is 75 degrees here. And the head scope is 3.5. This is reasonable or not. Okay. For the situation, firstly, I calculate the, for this equation, first I calculate the centigrees. Okay. After that, I calculate the Kelvin into step. First, the 35 Fahrenheit is equal to minus 32 divided by 1.8 is equal to Fahrenheit to centigrees. And this 35 Fahrenheit is 1.667 centigrees. For the situation, I put 315 Kelvin, 373.15 Kelvin. It means that 35 centigrade Fahrenheit, pardon, is equal to 274.817 Kelvin. In the same manner, 75 Fahrenheit is equal to 297.032 Kelvin. Okay. Firstly, to Fahrenheit to Kelvin. After that, we calculate the COP. Coefficient of performance. Okay. For maximum, maximum is the reversible one, as you know that, is equal to, I used this formulation, refrigerator, okay, maximum one. 1 divided by TH and TL minus 1 is equal to 1. This one, 297 point blah, blah, blah, divided by TL 274 point blah, blah, blah, minus 1 is equal to our COP of performance is the maximum heat coefficient of performance of refrigerators, 12.36. Okay. For the situation, maybe it can be like this. And for the situation, like this. But they said that this is 13.5. This is impossible. As you see, the claim is false. This is impossible because the maximum coefficient of performance is 12.36, but this claims that 13.5. This is impossible. Okay. And this is so easy example. Example 6-7, you can solve by your own. Okay. This is so easy. It's not so big issue. Again, you can use coefficient of performance of heat pump. It's not so big issue. Therefore, we finished this chapter. Okay, next week, or not, but not next week, next day, tomorrow, I mean tomorrow, we pass the NIF chapter. Okay, chapter 7, entropy. Now, we learn the second thermodynamic second law. And we know the thermal energy reservoir. We know the heat engines and refrigerators. After that, we know we learned the second law of thermodynamic of Kelvin, Planck statement, and Clausius statement. This is all same as you know that. And we looked at partial motion machines, which cannot be, which does not obey to thermodynamic first law and second law. And we looked at irreversible and irreversibilities. After that, for this lesson, Carnot cycle, totally reversible cycle, Carnot principle, temperature scale, and the Carnot heat engine quality of energy, and Carnot refrigerator and heat pump. Okay, guys, see you next day. Okey, bay bay.
İyi günler hocam.
Sağ olun hocam, iyi günler.
Hadi iyi günler gençler.